Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around, come gather around, come gather around. Look at this. Look at this tiny little guy. We had to zoom in a little bit so you can see it. It's small. It's a 145 MIG, but it'll do stick and TIG, and we need to find out if this is any good. Let's go!
I previously tested BestArc's plasma cutter, which was so awesome that I kept it, and it replaced my existing plasma cutter. So I was really excited to see how this would perform. I kind of like the color. It's got a funky sort of 50s sort of. It's different than all the other machines you typically see. The kit consists of all the stuff you would normally see in a welder. It has a reasonable stinger for doing stick. It's got its own kind of way of doing rollers to feed the MIG wire. The instructions are okay. They're not really a manual on how to weld. It just kind of gives you the basics on setting up and operating the weld, which works fine. There's two spools of wire, flux and solid core, and it's got its own kind of way of attaching it here. There's a crazy little plastic wheel that you need to put down before you put the wire through, which I figured out a little bit later on. So playing with it, I think I'm on 110 volts so far. The lowest it'll go is 50 amps. And on the bottom left, you've got the thickness of wire that you can choose from for largely the gasless. 2T for touch it to start and touch it to let go to stop, or 4T where you can touch it, let go, and it's still going on. With gas, you get up to 125 amps on 110, 145 amps on 220, and it's got TIG and stick options in the bottom right. There's also a tweakable thing where you push that knob and it gets you into setting where you can go just a little bit hotter or a little bit cooler, which I personally like. Easy controls to use.
Two of the most convenient and portable methods of welding are flux core MIG, which is not really technically MIG, but wire feeding flux core and stick. So it comes with a spool of flux core. Let's give this a go and see how it works. For flux core, you want the clamp to go to positive. Lucky for you, it's easy to change. And then the negative feeds the torch.
A smart cookie will always grind the metal nice and shiny. I think I'm using just a flap disc, and then we're doing the flux core. I don't have a lot of experience in flux core. It's definitely the way to go for outside where you might have a breeze or you just don't have a tank. And so I figured I'd push and drag just to see how it goes.
So 3/16 plate, 100 amps pushing, 125 amps dragging. But it comes with a spool of regular MIG wire, so I prefer that, and I'm going to run that with an argon CO2 mix. You could get yourself a really small bottle and still be relatively portable, but I'm running this on my regular bigger tank. So let's try this with regular MIG. For regular MIG welding, the clamp goes to negative. Lucky for you, it's easy to change. The torch gets positive. Let's go. We'll try it on stick. I hate stick, but we're gonna do some stick with this. Stick, another stick. This will do lift arc TIG. It doesn't come with a TIG torch, but you can pick one up at any welding supply shop or online. So I happen to have one here. This style, you have to turn on the little knob here to flow the argon to do the welding. You're gonna bring it up, touch it, get an arc going, do your welding, and then take this away, which isn't my favorite way of TIG welding, but you know, this is what lift arc is about. And it makes it affordable and portable. Ah, it's like a rhyming couplet. So we're gonna do that. So we're gonna set this up. For lift arc TIG, the clamp goes to positive. And my torch uses a different style, so I had to buy one of these. I just happen to have a torch that uses a larger DINS plug. So this is an adapter. So this will thread in here. And then the end of my torch goes into that.
Fresh out of the welder, this is what it's kind of looking like. I do prefer TIG over stick. Fresh out of the wire wheel to make it look a little more shiny. There it is. This thing had a really, really nice arc. Maybe a best arc. It just really smooth and wonderful arc coming out of the thing to do the TIG.
If we can TIG steel, we can TIG stainless. But can I push stainless through it? So I got a spool of 308L. I've got some exhaust cutoffs here. Normally you should back gas this because stainless tends to sugar on the back. Looks like tiny little barnacles. However, I'm just gonna put some Solar Flux B on the back. I've had good success with this. You just mix it with a bit of alcohol. Methanol is a good way to go. We'll coat the backside and then we'll see how that turns out.
I did 4-inch stainless exhaust on my 61 Chevy pickup. About 15 feet of pipe, I think, and I probably spent more in argon backgassing the whole exhaust system trying to weld it all together. Solar Flux is convenient, and it works really good. I don't have a whole lot of experience in MIG welding with stainless, but we're going to have a go. I have played with it in the past. We're giving it a go just for you.
So it can MIG aluminum, but it can TIG, so why would you? But it could if you felt you had to. I wasn't quite sure I got the settings right. I had some welds that were decent and some was a little bit too much wire feed. You can play with it. I like getting into here and like tweak it a little up or a little bit down and trying to find the right balance of heat with a little correction on there. It'll do it, but TIG is better. So I don't believe it mentions it in the instructions, but I wonder if I can push aluminum through it. I got a 5356 series aluminum, which is a little more rigid than a 4043. We'll push it through, run straight argon, and see if I can make aluminum through this, just for giggles. I would say yes, you can weld aluminum with it. Took me a little bit of screwing around with it, but that's what I got. You gotta be really close. That's all I'm saying, like really close. But it did it on 50 thou aluminum. So that's kind of impressive. BestArc, this thing can weld aluminum. So the size and portability of this is, I think, the greatest benefit of this welder. It's very small, it's very light. It's got a handle, it comes with a shoulder strap, so you can carry this around on your shoulder and do impromptu welding experiences wherever you might happen to be. It's got a relatively short whip on it, which again, it's portable, that's kind of the point behind it. We did Flux Core MIG. I'm not a big fan of Flux Core MIG, but if you're out and about and you need portability, you don't need a tank. You can just have a spool of Flux Core and this, and as long as you can get power to it, you can weld. So that's nice, that's a good feature with this. If you can get a tank of argon CO2 or straight CO2, if you're on a cost mindful thing, I did run the ER70 S6. It comes with a spool of Flux Core. It comes with a regular spool of solid core. I ran that with a 75-25 mix and it welded very satisfactorily. I do like that you can control the current with this, but you can always get in there and tweak it by pushing that and fine tuning a little hotter or a little colder, depending what you want. I tend to run my welding a little bit hotter than the charts or the auto set features do, and I like that I can go in and tweak that to where I like it to be. So no complaints with that at all. That was decent. We did lift arc TIG. I only did with steel. I didn't lift arc with stainless, but I know that steel and stainless pretty much weld the same. The arc on this for TIG was beautiful. It does not come with a TIG torch, but it's just a smaller dense style plug, so you can pick one of those up pretty much anywhere, Amazon, eBay. I bet you BestArc probably offers a torch for their equipment as well, but anything works, and it'll give you the TIG that you want. It does MIG weld stainless. There are settings, a chart inside that tell you the settings for running stainless. I pushed it through to see how it'd go, and I ran straight argon for stainless, and it worked, it was okay. I may need to spend a bit more time with it, but I have marginal experience MIG welding stainless. I TIG my stainless, and this can TIG. So since it can TIG, why would you MIG weld stainless? But it can, if that's what you need to do. And for giggles, I also was able to push aluminum through here, 5356 alloy, and you gotta stay really close, but they don't mention it in the booklet, but this thing, actually did aluminum and it was okay, but you gotta be pretty close. So yeah, I can do stainless, steel, stick, flux core, gas, aluminum, all in there, it's pretty cool. The greatest advantage is the size and portability, which is cool. And because it's small and compact and portable, that kind of limits how much power they can give you out of this machine, which is why it's a 145. If you want something that puts out more current, you're gonna have to get a bigger unit, which, you know, then I gotta go to the gym and work out more. But 145 will do a lot of stuff that you need to do. As a hobbyist homeowner, it's not often you're likely welding more than 3/16, and this can do your 1/8 inch, it's kind of pushing for 3/16, but it'll do pretty much everything a typical 110 welder will do. On 110 volts, it'll only give you 105 amps for stick welding, which is not quite enough for the only rods I get. The only rods I buy are 1/8 inch rods. You need to have 125 amps. So you plug it into 220, it will give you 125 amps, not more. So that's kind of your limitation with that. For MIG, on 110, this will give you 125 amps. If you want more, you gotta run 220. And it's definitely happier on 220, but you can do a fair bit with 110 volt. Again, it's the compactness of this. You know, if you want more power in a small container like this, you need to feed it more voltage. So the controls on the front are pretty easy to figure out. It's not rocket surgery here. So it's an impressive little unit. If you're after something that's compact, portable, and reasonably versatile, considering the size it is, give this a look. If it interests you, there's a link down below in the description. Check it out where you can pick up a BestArc MIG 145, if this is checking all the boxes of what you're looking for in a small, compact, portable, and versatile welder. I will be giving this to some lucky student next school year, someone who's heading into a welding program, so they have something to practice with at home. And thanks to BestArc for this, and I'm sure the kid's going to thank BestArc as well. As always, thanks for watching, take care, and we'll see you again.